वेट, आई विल जस्ट शेयर द स्क्रीन। एवरीवन कैन हियर मी प्रॉपरली? साउंड क्वालिटी इज ओके? ओके ओके, आई विल स्टार्ट। इट्स नियरली 3:20 नाउ। ओके, आई एम बिट लेट टुडे। लास्ट टाइम वी हैव सीन, और वी वेर स्टिल इन बर्न्स, वी आर लुकिंग इन टू द मैकेनिकल इंजुरीज एंड ऑल। सो वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द बर्न्स। सो डे बिफोर यस्टरडे we have seen burns. What are the degrees of burns and all? I'll just revise in short. Yes, these are the 3-degree burns. These are the 3 degrees of the burns. First degree, epidermal. Second degree, dermoepidermal. And third degree is deep burns. Depending upon which layers, how many layers of the skin and deep structures are affected, accordingly the burns are classified into 3 degrees. We have seen all these details, so first degree, second degree, third degree. Okay, so epidermal, dermoepidermal and deep. Then we have seen rule of 9, very important, also asked in exam very commonly. Rule of 9, depending upon how much surface area of the skin has been affected by the burns. It has been mentioned in rule of 9. So 4.5% for front of head, that is face, 4.5% for back, then 9% for each arm, 18% for front of back and abdomen, and 18% for behind, that is back, 9% for front and back of each leg, 9% in front and 9% for behind, and 1% perineum. So these two collectively accounts for 100% body surface area. So this is the photograph, this is the diagrammatic presentation of that. Then we have seen effects of the burns. Effect depend upon how much is the temperature, then what is the duration of exposure, for how much time the person has been exposed to the duration, then exposed to the fire, then extent and position. Surface area burnt is important. We have seen last time surface area burnt is important. Wider the surface area, more are the chances of complications. So first degree burns or wider area, first degree burn or wide part of the area, maybe 30%, 35%, 40%, will be more dangerous than third degree burn in very small area of the body. Then where the burn injuries are present, the burns present on the head, neck, face, trunk, genitalia are more dangerous as compared to the burn injuries on limbs. Then we have seen age of the burns, how that sloughing occurs and all, everything I have explained you in last lecture. Redness occurs immediately, vesication, formation of blister occurs within 2 to 3 hours, pus formation because of secondary infection.
नेट
Everyone can hear me? Everyone can hear me? Let me know. I have some network issues. Clear now? Yes. Yes, I had some network issues. Okay, okay. I will continue. I think this time it's better now. Okay. I will start. Then very important thing in case of burn injuries is cause of death. So when any person is exposed to the fire or has been trapped somewhere in the fire, what will be the cause of the death? Either because of severe pain because of burning, as well as because of fear, that is primary neurogenic shock. Then there can be severe pain or injury to the vital organs. Then secondary shock due to exudation of serum from burnt areas. We have seen in the last lecture, large amount of fluid part is exudating continuously from the burn injuries. That's why hemoconcentration occurs. Circulating volume of the blood is reduced, leading to circulatory collapse, and patient can go into shock. That is because of depletion of blood volume. Then asphyxia, because of inhalation of smoke. If any person has been trapped in any room, somewhere in the lift or in any building, and it is not possible for that person to escape from the fire, so he may not die because of the actual exposure to the fire, but because of inhalation of dangerous gases like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and products of combustion and all. And renal failure is because of shock. If the shock condition is maintained for more than 2 hours, kidneys are likely to fail, and that person will develop renal failure and will die because of the renal failure. Then postmortem appearance, we have seen external postmortem appearance. We have completed up to this slide. There will be strong smell of burning. Red blisters will be there. The blisters may be ruptured or collapsed. And then we have seen one more important thing. Which parts of the body are protected from burn injuries? The parts which are tightly closed, like wristband or some ornaments around the neck, or tight belt around the waist, or necktie, around these things, the fire injuries caused by the burns will be less severe. And where the loose clothes are there, limbs, trunk and all, here the chances of injuries will be more severe. Boxing attitude, I have explained you what is boxing attitude or pugilistic attitude. It is because of generalized flexion. It is caused by heat stiffening because of coagulation of the proteins because of exposure to the heat. This boxing attitude or pugilistic attitude occurs, and it is permanent, like rigor mortis. It doesn't pass off. You know, in rigor mortis secondary relaxation occurs and all the muscles get relaxed, but in case of pugilistic attitude, this stiffening is permanent because there is complete charring or denaturation of the proteins in the muscles. So that's why the skin also becomes leathery, hard, and it cannot be broken, or the muscles will not undergo secondary relaxation. Now let's see internal changes. I think we have finished up to here. Now we will see internal changes. Internal changes depend upon the whether the death has occurred by any other thing or by asphyxia, because there can be characteristic changes of asphyxia will be there. Then whether the death is because of complications like septicemia, pneumonia, or renal failure, acute tubular necrosis, that is renal failure. So if the person dies by asphyxia, what is asphyxia? Because of entry of irrespirable gases or poisonous gases and products of combustion into the respiratory tract while breathing, the oxygenation of the blood will be hampered, and patient will have that obstruction or difficulty in breathing, and the death will occur because of asphyxia. So any obstruction to the ventilation or oxygenation of the blood in the lungs. So if the person dies by asphyxia, the inhaled smoke will be seen as black particles, mixed with the mucus. So when you will open the lung, when you will open the respiratory tract like trachea, larynx and all, the respiratory tract or bronchial tree will be filled with ब्लैक पार्टिकल्स. मतलब कहीं भी आग लगने के बाद वो छोटे छोटे नहीं क्या वो उड़ते हैं वैसे छोटे छोटे वो ब्लैक कलर के पार्टिकल दोज प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ कंबशन दे विल बी इनहेल्ड एंड दे विल बी प्रेजेंट इन द रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक और ब्रोंकियल ट्री एंड इट विल बी मिक्सड विथ म्यूकस. ऑकेजनली द सूट और दोज ब्लैक पार्टिकल दे कैन बी इंजेस्टेड सो दे कैन ऑल्सो भी प्रेजेंट इन इसोफेगस एंड इट विल बी अ गुड साइन दैट द पर्सन वॉज अलाइव एट द टाइम ऑफ बर्निंग. मतलब जब वो मर गया जब वो आदमी जल रहा था सो एट दैट टाइम दैट बॉडी वेन दैट बॉडी वॉज बींग बर्न दैट मैन वॉज अलाइव. मतलब दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मेडिको लीगल थिंग बिकॉज समझो किसी को पॉइजनिंग करके गला दबा के या किसी और चीज़ से पहले उसको मार दिया और बाद में सुसाइड का सीन करने के लिए या एक्सीडेंट का सीन बनाने के लिए उसे अगर बॉडी को जला दिया गया तो इसोफेगस में गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टाइनल ट्रैक में वो सूट या ब्लैक पार्टिकल जाएंगे क्या? नहीं, बिकॉज दे कैन नॉट बी सॉलिड बाय द पर्सन बिकॉज द पर्सन वॉज ऑलरेडी डेड. लेकिन वो अगर जलने की वजह से ही मरता है सो ड्यूरिंग इनहेलेशन दिस सूट एंड ब्लैक पार्टिकल्स कैन बी ingested and they can be swallowed and they will be present in the esophagus. So this is important medico-legal point. If the soot or those black particles are ingested and they are found in the esophagus, it will show that the person was alive at the time of burning. Then there will be presence of froth and froth will be present in the trachea and bronchi. Froth will be present in trachea and bronchi. Then, because of the exposure to too much heat and inflammatory changes, the tracheal mucosa will be necrosed. It will be necrosed with detachment of the mucosa. Lungs will be shrunken and congested. So you'll have to open the thorax, thoracic cage. You'll have to open the lungs and see into the lungs for postmortem appearances. So lungs will show shrunken and congested lungs will be there. Then pleural cavities may contain blood-stained effusion. Pleural cavities, when you will open the pleura, pleura will show the blood-stained effusion. Petechial hemorrhage. Now, petechial hemorrhage is a characteristic feature of aspexia. So, not only in burn, by any means, if the person has died by aspexia, this petechial hemorrhage. What do you mean by petechial hemorrhage? Anyone? What do you mean by petechial hemorrhage? Anyone? What do you mean by petechial hemorrhage? Prasad, you have unmute yourself. What is petechial hemorrhage? Gela, like is gayab zala. Okay. Anyone, what is petechial? You might have heard it, studied it in physiology as well as in pathology also. You might have completed somewhere. What is petechial hemorrhage? Anyone? Spotty hemorrhage. Spotty bleeding in the skin or in the mucosa. I say patches may dikhega. In which condition it occurs? Anyone? In which condition it occurs? Bleeding disorders like purpura. Have you heard purpura? Anyone knows what is purpura? Okay, so what happens in aspexia? There is petechial hemorrhage. Petechial hemorrhage in the conjunctiva, petechial hemorrhage anywhere in the body, in the skin, or mainly on the face. So the petechial hemorrhage will be seen in many organs. Heart chambers are also full with the blood. And the blood is thick because of loss of water. Because of loss of water, the blood is thick, what we call it as hemoconcentration. This again, one important 2-mark question, Kunkel's test. Kunkel's test will indicate amount of carbon monoxide in the blood. If more than 10% of carbon monoxide is present in the blood, that means the person was alive at the time of burning. I told you one very important medical legal aspect. कोई भी ऐसी डेड बॉडी मिलती है जैसे तुम्हें पता चला है कि ये जलने की वजह से मौत हुई है, मतलब सीवियर बर्न इंजुरी प्रेजेंट ऑन द बॉडी, सो हाउ विल यू कम टू नो कि यह सचमुच जल के ही मरा है या इसे पॉइजनिंग करा के या गला दबा के या दूसरा कुछ करके उसे मार डाला है और बाद में सुसाइड का या एक्सीडेंट का सीन क्रिएट करने के लिए उसे जला दिया गया, बाद में डेड बॉडी को जला दिया गया या घर को जला दिया गया. सो इफ़ 10% और मोर कार्बन मोनोक्साइड इज़ डिटेक्टेड इन द ब्लड, दैट मीन्स दैट पर्सन हैज़ इनहेल्ड दैट मच कार्बन मोनोक्साइड. द पर्सन हैज़ इनहेल्ड दैट मच कार्बन मोनोक्साइड एट द टाइम ऑफ बर्न्स, सो द पर्सन वॉज अलाइव. मतलब उसकी मौत जलने की वजह से ही हुई है. दैट इज कंकेल्स टेस्ट. देन फ्रैक्चर ऑफ स्कैल्प ड्यू टू हीट. ऑन नेक्स्ट पोस्टमार्टम एग्जामिनेशन यू विल गेट द फ्रैक्चर ऑफ स्कैल्प. सो स्कैल्प विल बी बर्स्ट ओपन ड्यू टू हीट, mainly in the temporal region. The brain will be congested and edematous swollen and there can be extradural hemorrhage. Bleeding in the extradural space. These all are the post-mortem appearance in case of burns. Now, what are the medico-legal aspect of burns? If any dead body has been found in a burnt condition, what are the different medico-legal aspects? So first important thing, you should be able to identify that body. So identification is the most important medico-legal aspect. So you'll have to identify the body, whether it is male, whether it is female, then approximate age, first of all sex, then approximate age, and finally name and age and all. So you should be able to identify the body, because clothes might be burned, the face might have been badly burnt, genitalia might have been badly burnt, so it will be very difficult to detect whether it is a male or female body. So first important thing is identification of the body, then whether the burns are antemortem or postmortem. What we have discussed in at least two times, whether that person has died by burns only or whatever the burn injuries are seen or present on the body are postmortem burns. मतलब उससे पहले गला दबा के poisoning करके या कुछ तो पहले मार डाला और बाद में body को जला दिया गया. So whether these burns are antemortem means ड्यूरिंग लिविंग और पोस्टमार्टम मरने के बाद की इंजुरी है क्या. सो द बर्न इंजुरीज वेदर दे आर एंटीमार्टम और पोस्टमार्टम, दैट विल बी द इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट और इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट द डॉक्टर विल हैव टू सी वाइल डूइंग द पोस्टमार्टम एग्जामिनेशन. एंड वेन यू विल कंसिडर दैट बर्निंग इज अ कॉज ऑफ डेथ, कि ये आदमी की मौत, इस आदमी की मौत जलने की वजह से ही हुई है. दैट हाउ विल यू कम टू नो, बिकॉज ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑफ सूट इन द एयर पैसेज. इफ द सूट इज प्रेजेंट इन द एयर पैसेज एज वेल एज इन द इसोफेगस, दैट मीन्स द पर्सन वॉज अलाइव एट द टाइम ऑफ बर्निंग. मतलब वो जलने की वजह से ही उसकी मौत हुई है, क्योंकि उसके बगैर तो वो इनहेल नहीं कर पाएगा, स्वेलो नहीं कर पाएगा दैट सूट एंड ऑल दोज ब्लैक पार्टिकल्स ऑफ फायर एंड ऑल और प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ कंबशन. They will be present and will be mixed with the blood and mucus in the respiratory tract as well as in some cases in the esophagus. Then another thing is cherry red blood. If the blood on postmortem examination, if you find the blood as cherry red color, so cherry red color is because of carbon monoxide. So when large amount of carbon monoxide has been inhaled, it will be carried to the blood from alveolar capillary membrane. It will be carried to the blood into the circulation, and the blood will become that carboxyhemoglobin will give the blood cherry red like color. So that is called a cherry red blood, characteristic feature of carbon monoxide poisoning. And antemortem blisters ki bhajlyacha zakhma, wo jalne ki wajah se jo bhi injuries hue, those burn injuries are whether they are antemortem or postmortem. These are the sure signs of death by burn. If these things are present, antemortem blisters, cherry red blood and soot in the air passage, I have written it in bold, these three are very important or sure signs of death by burning, ki is aadmi ki maut jalne ki wajah se hi hui hai. Now you have confirmed that the person is died by burning, jalne ki wajah se hi maut hui hai. Now important medical aspect will be whether those burns are suicidal, accidental or homicidal. Jalne ki wajah se hui hai. वेट फॉर सेकंड. एम्ब्रोक्सन
मॉन्टिकोममध्ये ॲम्ब्रोक्झेल नाही आहे. मॉन्टिकोममध्ये ॲम्ब्रोक्झेल नाही आहे. मॉन्टिकोप ए हा अर्धी अर्धी एच एस नाही, अर्धी गोळी फक्त रात्री एक टाईम.
ओके सो सूट प्रेझेंट इन द एअर पॅसेज, चेरी रेड ब्लड बिकॉज ऑफ कार्बन मोनॉक्साइड एंड एंटीमार्टम ब्लिस्टर्स. एंटीमार्टम ब्लिस्टर्स क्योंकि अगर डेड बॉडी को जलाया जाता है तो उस पर ब्लिस्टर्स नहीं आएंगे. इन्फ्लामेटरी साइंस एंड ब्लिस्टर्स विल बी एबसेंट. सो एंटीमार्टम ब्लिस्टर्स विल बी एबसेंट इन केस ऑफ बर्निंग ऑफ द डेड बॉडी. एंड वंस इट हैज़ बीन कन्फर्म दैट द पर्सन इज डेड बाय बर्निंग ओनली, वेदर इट वॉज सुसाइड उसने खुद को जला के लिया है, इट वॉज एक्सीडेंट और होमिसाइडल किसी ने उसे जला के मार दिया है, दैट इज द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ मेडिकल लीगल इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो वेदर द बर्न्स आर सुसाइडल, एक्सीडेंटल और होमिसाइडल. सो दिस इज अबाउट द बर्न्स. So burns is asked as a 10 mark question. It's very commonly it is asked as a 10 mark question in question number 4. Got everyone? You want me to repeat any topic? Everyone understood? Are bolo. अंजली व्हाय आर यू अनम्यूट? ओके देन गॉट एवरीवन अबाउट द मेडिको लीगल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ बर्न्स. Suit in the air passage, cherry red color blood because of inhaled carbon monoxide and antemortem blisters because blisters will occur in case of antemortem burns. म्हणजे जिवंत माणसाला जर कोणी भाजलं किंवा असं पेटून दिलं तर त्याच्या अंगावर भाजल्याच्या जखमा फोड्या येतील. डेड बॉडीला जाळलं तर ब्लिस्टर्स येणार नाहीत. सो antemortem burns दिस आर द sure signs of death by burning, and after that important is whether that death by burning is or death by burns is because of suicidal. त्याने स्वतः स्वतःला पेटवून घेतलंय, ॲक्सिडेंटल चुकून कुठेतरी आग लागली आणि त्याच्यामध्ये तो वाजला आहे की ऑर इट इज अ होमिसाइडल कोणी जाणून बुजून त्याला पेटवून दिले. सो दॅट विल बी द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन. इफ द डेथ हॅज बीन कन्फर्म्ड बाय बर्न्स वेदर इट वॉज सुसाइडल, ॲक्सिडेंटल ऑर होमिसाइडल. So here we have finished with burns. Any problem? Anyone? Any problem with burns? Have you got understood everything from the burns? Everyone? Got everyone? Bola bola. Any problem? Any query?
Hello. हाँ. नको नको ते नको नको. अरे फॉर्मॅलिटी फिक्स असतात रे बाबा आमची. बरं दे सर, किती 20 टिपचं बॉक्स आहे का? दे 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 चल. दे आज देतो का आणून? 6. हो नारायणगाव मध्ये. नाही ना उद्या, उद्या पेपर आहे. नाही येणार का असतो नारायणगावला? अरे यार नाही उद्या येणार आहे मी, जाऊ दे उद्या. नको उद्या उद्या. हा 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 चालेल.
Okay then, we have finished with burns here. Now we'll go to next important topic, aspexia. Again, aspexia is also very commonly asked as a 10 mark question, in question number 4 only. पडलेलं पाठव तिला, नेट गेले, नेट गेले तिला ना, तिला पाठवलं इकडे मोबाईल तिचा. Okay, we'll start with new topic, aspexia. Aspexia is commonly asked as a 10 mark question. No, not as a whole aspexia. There are so many topics. There are so many type of topics in aspexia only. The question on aspexia can be, what are the stages of aspexia? What is aspexia? And explain the stages of aspexia, that we'll see in detail. So, aspexia is a condition, you might have heard this term so many times. So, aspexia is a condition in which oxygen supply to the blood and tissues has been reduced. Oxygen supply to the blood and tissues has been reduced. Why? Because of interference with the respiration. So, if respiration is obstructed by any means, now we'll see what are the different ways or what are the different mechanisms by which the respiration can be obstructed. So, anything that will cause interference with the respiration will lead to oxygenation of the blood. So, condition in which oxygen supply to the blood and tissues has been reduced by interference with respiration is the in general definition of aspexia. And in forensic medicine, oxygen lack caused by mechanical interference with respiration. Respiration madhe kuthlahi adthala zalyamule kay hoil, the blood will not be oxygenated in the lungs, and the condition developed is called as aspexia. So got everyone, what is aspexia? So aspexia is because of any interference, mechanical interference with the respiration. Now there are three stages. There are three stages of aspexia. One is inspiratory dyspnea, means when the aspexia will start, patient will have difficulty in inspiration. What do you mean by dyspnea? Dyspnea is difficult breathing. Difficulty in breathing. So that difficulty in breathing will be first felt during inspiration. So, inspiratory dyspnea, where the patient will have rapid and deep labored breathing. Just hold for a second. HS, Ratri. 5 ml at bedtime. Okay. So inspiratory dyspnea, patient will have difficulty during inspiration. So patient will have rapid, deep and labored breathing. मतलब उसको सांस लेते वक्त, अंदर लेते वक्त बहुत ज़्यादा तकलीफ होगी. Extraordinary muscles are also brought into play for inspiration. Now you know the muscles of respiration. डायफ्रॅम, इंटरनल इंटरकॉस्टल मसल, एक्सटर्नल एक्स्ट्राकॉस्टल मसल्स अँड सो मेनी मसल्स विच जनरली प्ले सपोर्ट इम्पॉर्टंट रोल फॉर नॉर्मल ब्रिदिंग. बट एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी मसल्स लाइक स्टर्नोक्लेटोमस्टॉइड अँड सम मसल्स इन द नेक, दे ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रॅक्ट टू सपोर्ट द रेस्पिरेशन. दॅट्स वाय वी हॅव मेन्शन्ड एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी मसल्स आर ब्रॉट इन टू प्ले. देन पेशंट विल बिकम रेस्टलेस, अँक्शियस लुक. आता श्वास घेता येत नाही त्यामुळे पेशंटला असं घाबरल्यासारखा चेहरा होईल पेशंटचा. अँक्शियस लुक, राईज इन ब्लड प्रेशर अँड पल्स रेट. द नाव बिकॉज द ऑक्सिजनेशन ऑफ द ब्लड हॅज बीन हॅम्पर्ड. नाव पेशंट द फेस अँड नेल्स विल बिकम ब्ल्यू बिकॉज ऑफ सर्क्युलेशन ऑफ द डीऑक्सिजनेटेड ब्लड. द फेस अँड नेल्स विल बिकम ब्ल्यू. देन सेकंड स्टेज विल बी एक्सपायरेटरी डिस्नेया. प्लीज सी द नेम्स केअरफुली. इंस्पायरेटरी डिस्नेया, डिफिकल्टी इन इन्स्पिरेशन. नाव एक्सपायरेटरी डिस्नेया मीन्स हिअर द अस्पेक्ट जे आय विल बिकम मोर सिव्हिअर. नाव यु नो इन्स्पिरेशन इज अ ॲक्टिव्ह प्रोसेस अँड एक्सपायरेशन इज अ पॅसिव्ह प्रोसेस. एक्सपिरेशन करण्यासाठी, आत घेतलेली हवा बाहेर सोडण्यासाठी, एक्सपिरेशनसाठी आपल्याला काही विशेष मेहनत लागत नाही. श्वास घेताना थोडीशी ताकद लावायला लागते आपल्याला. नॉर्मली नॉर्मली थोडीशी मेहनत करणी पडते सांस लेने के लिए, लेकिन छोडने के लिए तो दॅट इज अ पॅसिव्ह थिंग. लेकिन वेन द ॲस्पेक्ट जे विल बिकम मोर सिव्हिअर, नाव द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सपायरेशन विल ऑल्सो बिकम डिफिकल्ट. सो दॅट्स वाय इट इज कॉल्ड ॲज एक्सपायरेटरी डिस्निया. सो एक्सपायरेटरी डिस्निया इज बिकॉज ऑफ लॅक ऑफ ऑक्सिजन अँड रिटेन्शन ऑफ कार्बन डायऑक्साईड. सो नॉट ओनली लॅक ऑफ ऑक्सिजन बट रिटेन्शन ऑफ कार्बन डायऑक्साईड विल ऑल्सो प्ले अ रोल नाव. अँड स्टॅग्नेशन ऑफ डीऑक्सिजनेटेड ब्लड विल ऑकर इन द व्हेन्स अँड कॅपिलरी. सो व्हेन्स अँड कॅपिलरीज विल बी लोडेड विथ डीऑक्सिजनेटेड ब्लड अँड नाव द पेशंट विल हॅव लेबर्ड ब्रिदिंग. दॅट पर्सन विल हॅव लेबर्ड ब्रिदिंग. क्लाउडिंग ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस मतलब अभी उसका दिमाग पे भी असर होगा बिकॉज ऑफ अकुमुलेशन ऑफ कार्बन मोनॉक्साइड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड लैक ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. पेशेंट कैन हैव कन्वर्जेंस एंड रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ ऑल द स्फिंक्टर्स. नाउ इन फर्स्ट स्टेज फेस एंड नेल्स विल बिकम ब्लू बट नाउ इन द सेकंड स्टेज दैट इज एक्सपायरेटरी डिस्निया फेस एंड हैंड्स विल बी डीपली साइनोस. पहिल्या स्टेजपेक्षा now in second stage the cyanosis will be more severe. So face and hands will be deep blue or deeply cyanosed. Then blood stained fluid from mouth and nose. There will be oozing of blood stained fluid from mouth and nose. Tongue will be protruded. That may be bitten by the teeth. Eyeballs will be prominent and there will be cadaveric spasm. We have seen what is cadaveric spasm. So cadaveric spasm is a modification of rigor mortis. So immediately after death without primary relaxation, if any person dies by aspexia, patient will not have primary relaxation. So jo pehle all the muscles undergo relaxation in the stage of changes in muscles, that primary relaxation is followed by rigor mortis and rigor mortis is followed by secondary relaxation. But if any person dies by aspexia, primary relaxation will not occur and person will directly develop that spastic condition or the stiffening and shortening of the muscles, what we call it as cadaveric spasm. It may affect only a few groups or maybe the whole body. So that is stiffening of the body without primary relaxation is called as cadaveric spasm. Okay, so these are the first two stages. Stage of inspiratory dyspnea where patient will have difficult inspiration. The stage of expiratory dyspnea where the passive process of expiration will also be difficult. The hands and nails, fingers will be deeply cyanosed. Oozing of frothing from mouth and nose, blood stained fluid from mouth and nose. Tongue will be protruded and there will be, if the person dies in this stage, patient will have cadaveric spasm. And third important or last stage of aspexia is respiratory paralysis. So because of lack of oxygen, now respiratory center present in the brain will get paralyzed. Loss of consciousness, patient behosh ho jayega. Loss of consciousness, पेशंट विल हैव इनफ्रीक्वेंट एंड शैलो रेस्पिरेशन दैट इज गैस्पिंग. गैस्पिंग मतलब वो बहुत मेहनत से ऐसे सांस लेने की कोशिश कर रहा है, दैट इज गैस्पिंग. नाउ ब्लड प्रेशर एंड पल्स रेट विल बी रिड्यूस्ड, मसल्स विल बी फ्लैसिड, ऑल द रिफ्लेक्सेस विल बी लॉस्ट, pupils will be widely dilated, pupils will be widely dilated and there will be terminal vomiting. The patient can vomit and will die immediately after the vomiting. And there can be incontinence of urine and feces. If the person dies by aspexia, the heart may keep on beating for 10 to 15 minutes even after the cessation of respiration. But recovery is not possible. If any person has been brought to the hospital during this stage, recovery is not possible because of cerebral anoxia. Because you know, the first organ that is to be affected by anoxia, hypoxia or anoxia, that is lack of oxygen, is brain. And whatever the trauma that has been caused to the brain by anoxia is irreversible. So patient will die surely, even though the heart is beating for 10 to 15 minutes after the cessation of respiration, recovery is not possible. Patient cannot be revived from this condition. So these are the three stages of aspexia: inspiratory dyspnea, difficult inspiration, expiratory dyspnea, all the symptoms will become more severe, and respiratory paralysis, that is paralysis of the respiratory center present in the brain, and all these things will take place. So this is about aspexia. Okay, then I think you have got Golap Madam's lecture at 4 p.m. no? Okay, I think we should stop here now, because now madam's lecture will start. Okay, then we'll stop here. See you next time, tomorrow my lecture may be at 5 p.m. because tomorrow I have got last theory paper of fourth year, final year ka kal theory paper hai, so I may be late from college. So I will tell you the time. I will tell you the time in the WhatsApp group when I will take the lecture, preferably or maybe at 5 p.m. So kal ka lecture shayad 5 baje hoga. Accordingly, I will notify you in the groups. Okay, then see you. Bye, everyone. Thank you. Tomorrow, most probably at 5 p.m., I will message accordingly. Okay, then I will end the meeting for all. Okay, bye. Bye.